Good morning, St. Andrews College. I'm David Osa-Ogbeide, and this is SAC Today. Hit it, Willer. February is Black History Month. As a Black student, I am truly appreciative of how welcomed SAC has made me feel, especially in the Black Culture Society. Since the introduction of the Society last year, it has helped me and other Black students feel more at home. The Society provides a space for us to really be who we are as people and not feel any judgment. For me personally, I've had so much more fun, and I feel like I have people here that I'm more comfortable asking for support. Having other students that look like me has always been a really big help. Past students like Sidney Wambua, Tanai Gorima, and David Azude have all connected with me on cultural levels in my time here. The Black Culture Society and other affinity groups are a big part of why students feel welcome here. To younger Black students watching this, there's a place for you at St. Andrews and the BCS. With so many talented students, the Arts Council hosted a paint night recently. Marcus Knoop has more on the story.
This year, the Arts Council ran paint night. I had the chance to speak to some of the guys at this event.
Hi, my name is Nelson Yang. I'm a grade 11 student here at SAC, and I paint sometimes.
Hi, my name is Jonathan, and I am in grade 11.
I've been enjoying paint night decently so far, I guess. It's been really fun. Just get here with the lads, paint a bit, you know.
Oh, I think it's been really awesome. It's a great experience, especially since I got Hugh here with me and Nelson, who I forced to come here as well. I think it's a great opportunity and I'm having a lot of fun, yeah.
I would say I signed up for paint night because, I mean, I wanted to paint, but I think the real reason is because Jonathan Rim, he made me sign up, so. I think what I like most about painting is just getting to express yourself, you know. You have paint, you have a canvas, you can really do anything you want. It's also just a great way to relax. Shout out to Wellness Council. It's a really good way to just chill, you know, have fun.
I don't really have much experience with painting, but from tonight I can say that I really enjoy how it doesn't have to be perfect and you can always keep adding on to it even if you make a mistake. Tonight we painted a Winter Wonderland themed painting.
For SAC Today, I'm Marcus Knoop.
Environmental Council member and SAC Today senior correspondent Noah Savage hosted the annual clothing drive to promote sustainable fashion practices. Let's turn it over to Noah for more.
The second annual Clothes for a Cause drive kicked off on January 28th. Last year, we raised over 100 pounds of clothing, and I wanted to get even more donations this year. I decided to sit down with one of our donors for this year to see what motivates him to donate to the cause.
My name is James, and I'm in grade 12. I donated to the clothing drive so I could spread awareness against the fast fashion industry. I mean, everyone's got a lot of extra clothes lying around their house, so I'm sure that they'll probably never wear again. So it doesn't hurt to donate it. You know, you're helping people out when you do, and it's not much of a hassle for you.
Thank you very much, James.
Like James, I would like to thank anyone who donated to the clothing drive this year. Get your piles ready for next year, St. Andrews. For SAC Today, I'm Noah Savage.
The Sports Desk returns for their second installment today. Off to Ben and Gray with your sports news.
Welcome to the Sports Desk.
Your source of everything athletics. Whether it's the B-Team Beauties or the NFL, we got it covered. I'm Ben Fitzpatrick.
And I'm Gray Berman.
And this is episode 2 of the Sports Desk. As we all know, the Swiftie Chiefs won this year's Super Bowl. Let's take a look at some of the highlights.
Jawan Jennings, trick play. Oh, this ball's in the air.
for a long time. McCaffrey's able to pull it down, and he's going in for the touchdown.
Now you think the 49ers can blow a 10-point lead, right?
I can only feel the number of people out there being like, what's going on?
First and goal. Mahomes flings it. It's there! Hardman! Jackpot, Kansas City!
Kermit wins again. You gotta feel for Anna Fry.
Neither of the teams deserve to be there anyways. The Lions lost because their coach doesn't like to kick field goals. And the Ravens, well, I'm not sure what happened to the Ravens.
That wraps up this exciting season of the NFL. Finally, February 2nd marked the annual Winter Activity Day at St. Andrews College. Students had the opportunity to choose an activity that embraced the winter season in Canada.
Whether it was conquering the slopes, the thrill of snow tubing, giving back to the community, or scoring goals on the ice, it was a day to remember. Everyone had a great time, including Mr. Colodi.
Thanks for joining us at the Sports Desk. We'll see you after March break.
Still in frame,
man. That might be funny, though.
Still on sports, senior correspondent Tom Williamson has a story on my team, Varsity Basketball. Let's take a look.
I checked in with your Varsity Saints basketball team on their thoughts on the season.
Yeah. Sometimes we laugh, sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now.
Gabe, how does it feel being 20 years old and still being in high school?
Feels great. Can't wait to go for my 21st year next year. Go Saints.
Thank you. I'm here with
David Osa-Ogbeide.
David, can you tell me a bit more about yourself?
I'm a grade 12 at St. Andrews College. I'm a varsity basketball captain this season. I've been here since grade 10.
Can you describe one of your most memorable games this season?
The most memorable game this season, for sure, probably for me, was the championship game at the Whitby tournament. That game was really close all the way through, and we really deserved that win. And personally, I've kind of given it my all, and I'm really happy with how I've played. But the team, I'm also really happy with the guys. Like, these guys, this is a big group of guys. Really tried really hard, we practiced really hard, we really improved a lot since the beginning of the season. So I'm really happy with our season so far.
Thank you. I'm here with
Coach Ludwig, First Basketball.
So, Coach, how do you feel the team has done this year?
I think we're off to a fantastic season so far. Guys are playing team basketball at both ends of the floor. It's really nice to see when they dig in on defense and definitely reaching their potential. So we got to buckle down for the last two games of CISA, and we're going to have a great time tonight with a great crowd here in Bedard, and then we'll see how it plays out in the playoffs.
What are you most proud of regarding the team's performance this season?
I think if you watch our games where we've really excelled, Halifax, Grammar, TCS, when we've had a great crowd like this, the guys play together at both ends of the floor. They play basketball the right way. They're making the extra pass. They're diving for loose balls. They're finishing possessions with box outs. It's not a lot of individual play, and that's not easy at the high school level. And so I'm really proud of them for that.
Thank you, Coach.
Award season, where millionaires get together to give each other golden statues, is almost over. So far, the Golden Globes, Emmys, Grammys, Junos, and BAFTA Awards are all done. And now only the biggest, the Academy Awards, is left. So here are some of SAC Today's predictions for some of the major winners on Oscar night. First up, actor in a leading role. And the Oscar goes to Jeffrey Wright for American Fiction. His pitch-perfect portrayal of an aging author in crisis shines light on the unique challenges and obstacles facing Black artists and creators. Taking home the Oscar for actor in a supporting role is none other than Robert Downey Jr. for his role as Frenemy Number One in Oppenheimer. Yes, Iron Man himself adds depth and brilliance to the cinematic masterpiece. The Oscar for actress in a leading role goes to Emma Stone for Poor Things. She delivers a career-defining performance in a weird and fantastic film that has people buzzing. For actress in a supporting role, the Oscar goes to Davine Joy Randolph for her portrayal of the school cook in The Holdovers. This story hits close to home, reminding us of our own boarding school experiences and the incredible staff who support us. On to the Oscar for the Best Animated Feature, Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse swings its way into victory, proving once again that Sony's groundbreaking animation style can't be beat, and that Miles Morales is the best Spider-Man. Last but not least, the moment we've all been waiting for, drumroll please. Oppenheimer takes home the prestigious award for Best Picture. At least, that's what Mr. Wyatt told me. Did any of you guys even watch this movie?
needs to know what's next.
Two.
What's next?
One.
For all you aspiring filmmakers, we have a new competition. Introducing the SAC Shorts Short Film Competition. Students can submit original short videos, 5 minutes or less, that could be documentary, fictional, or an original music video. The winners will receive prizes and have their work screened at the Focus Festival of Arts, and maybe even in an episode of SAC Today. Look for more info on the SBG Upper School News Conference, and good luck. That's it for our episode of SAC Today. I'm David Osa-Ogbeide, and thank you for watching.